Hey guys, it's Brittany, and today I have a little quick Disneyland update to show you guys. So first of all, as we go in, I just want to go ahead and check in with all of you. I hope you all are doing okay with the coronavirus still out and about, and I hope you all are staying at home, safe and healthy, and yeah, just stay at home, guys. Don't go out or anything. Go out if you really, really need to, but just stay at home. Anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and start in Frontierland. So I already did the entire Big Thunder Mountain, so it's a lot more smooth. It's no longer blocky like it used to be. So yeah, this is the new updated Thunder Mountain. Doesn't it look amazing, you guys? It's so cool. And I, of course, replaced it with the new Mine Coaster. So the track is, for the most part, the same, but there's a teeny tweaks here and there, but you won't really notice much of a difference. But it's definitely a lot more popular than the old Night Train coaster was, with the Junior coaster, whatever you called it. So I did change this part, so now you kind of go out like a curve, you come down like at a curve and stuff instead of going straight. So yeah. So that's, and in that epic music you just heard, that is a song called Foggy Mountain. It was a very popular song on Roblox back in the day, and I thought it would fit with the theme because, you know, it's Western, Old West, you know. I thought it would fit the theme, like, to me I thought it worked, so, yeah. Alright, for the second part of the update, so there is a huge update going on in Fantasyland right now. I am redoing a lot of the exterior parts of a couple of the rides, and there is a new ride coming to Fantasyland. You guys are going to be so happy when I show you this. So let's go in and check it out. I thought long and hard if I wanted to show you guys this or not yet, but I figured, well, I'll show you guys what we got going on, we just won't ride nothing. And oop, I lagged. Okay, there we go. So starting off, we have a new carousel that I just redid. Smaller, where it would fit better, and there's more walk space now. And then, yeah. And then I completely redid the exterior of Peter Pan. So I looked at Google Images, and I figured, well, I think I can do better. So this is the new Peter Pan exterior. My friend Beelzoo helps me work on it a little bit, but yes, it's way better. Like a lot of people who I've shown, they said it looks way better. So yep, that's the new exterior for Peter Pan. And then this is the new Dumbo that I worked on with Beelzoo. Beelzoo did this. All the credit for Dumbo goes to Beelzoo. He completely redid it, and he made it look really, really cool. And so I asked what the rainbow thing on the top was supposed to be. He said there's like a rainbow spear ball that's on the very top that the mouse, what's his face, Jasper is on. So that's what that's supposed to represent, that rainbowish ball on top. So yeah, that's new Dumbo. Now for the announcement, we officially have a new ride in Fantasyland that is actually finished as of now. But we're not going to check it out, and I will explain a little bit. Get ready. 3, 2, 1. Snow White's Scary Adventures is now at Disneyland. I bet you guys were freaking out right now. Like, oh my god! Brittany finally added Snow White! Yes, you guys, I finally added Snow White. I figured that old building I had here was so ugly and stupid. So yes, you guys, Snow White is finally at Disneyland. I cannot wait to show you guys the ride when I get to that point. But it won't be in today's video, sadly. But I will be in a video coming up, don't worry. So you have that Snow White. And over here, as you can see, this is going to be Pinocchio's daring journey. Now, don't get too excited. Because I don't have enough space underground to make the ride, it's just the exterior of the building. And then the inside, I was going to put, like, my friend recommends I do, like, either a gift shop or something here. I was thinking I'd do, like, a small, gentle ride or something to put in here. Like, you need even, like, a mini vintage... Like, Neela just, like, a mini dark ride going in a circle here and call it a day. Can't put it underground because I have Snow White using, like, literally, the ride Snow White takes up this entire area underground right here. And it even extends way out here towards, like, Peter Pan and stuff. So, yeah, Snow White is this big underground. It's huge. So, I cannot put the actual Pinocchio's ride in here. Which is okay to Chris, to the official Chris. He does not really care for Pinocchio, so he was happy that I'm not adding it. So, yeah, I hope you're happy, Chris. I'm not adding it. But I have the building, so you can suck on that. Otherwise, I'm just going to have like either a small ride in here or maybe a gift shop like my friend was telling me. I can even do both. Who knows? So that's what the Pinocchio's daring journey is going to be. Just the exterior, then a small ride or gift shop inside. For the second announcement, so... Alice in Wonderland and the teacups are going to be moved. So let me go ahead and explain. So the teacups ride here is actually going to be moved right here. It's this little center square right here. So you'll see the teacups right here being moved right here. And then this, so as of then, once I is moved, this new area right here, this little square, is going to be the new Mr. Toad ride. Now, I'm going to go ahead and tell you guys, I have no idea if I'm going to be able to fit that or not. I can definitely make the exterior, but the ride, I do not know. So, don't get your hopes up for that ride. Because otherwise, I don't think I'll be able to put it underground, because I think Peter Pan takes up that space right there underground. But if I have room, I will definitely put it there. Otherwise, it might just be like a small vintage car ride inside. But yeah, so that's going to be Mr. Toad's Wild Ride in the future right there. The teacups, like I said, will be moved to that circle here. So, as for the, Alice in Wonderland, I have decided I'm going to completely demolish it and I'm going to start over on it. So what I mean by that is I'm going to literally delete everything. And now Alice in Wonderland is going to be literally turned around and it's going to face this way. The way I'm looking right now, it'll face this way instead. And I also decided too that when I do that, I'm going to probably expand it more. So I might actually remove some of this stuff right here, like these rides, for example. So yeah, Alice in Wonderland is going to be completely deleted, and it's going to be brand new, and it's going to be way better than what it is currently. So yeah, that's what's up. That's what's coming up for the Fantasyland update, you guys. So Fantasyland is going to be closed for a long time. So you guys aren't going to be able to go on anything in here or do any of this. And even a small robe I'm going to be closing soon too, because I'm going to be redoing that as well. So literally, this entire area is going to be redone. So it's going to look brand new and fresh when it reopens. So yeah, that's what's coming up for Disneyland, you guys. I told you guys that when I finished making Disney World, I was going to focus on Disneyland again. And I am keeping my word to that. Hey, Lorena, what you doing, girl? Where you going? You want to buy a hat souvenir? Honey, you can't... Not even a hat will cover up that disgusting haircut. Anyway, I thought it would be a good time to go on Alice in Wonderland one more time before it shuts down. Because I am going to demolish it after this video is posted. So yeah, we're going to go on it one more time. Just to say goodbye to it. It's been here since the park opened, you know? It's kind of sad. So here we go, guys. Enjoy the last ride of Alice in Wonderland before it's what I just said. Anyway, so as for it's a small roll, I'm going to tell you guys what we're doing for this ride. Not much is really going to change on the outside of it, because I think it already looks fine the way it is. So we're not going to probably change anything outside. Besides, I am going to add another song to the playlist. I'm going to add the parade clock song that goes off like every half hour or whatever of the ride. So you guys are going to hear that at the when it reopens. Then on the inside, I was talking to Beelzoo, we're going to be removing all of the dolls that are currently in here, and we're going to be, like, replacing them with, like, new dolls. Because, honey, let's admit it, these dolls look like, and I quote, dancers. And we do not need that here. This is a child's theme park. This is for children. And children should not be exposed to that. So we're going to be replacing a lot of dolls, and maybe we'll redo the track a little bit. I haven't really fully decided yet. That's just on my the agenda right now. So that's upcoming for It's a Small World. And then I had a friend ask me if I was gonna do anything to the Matterhorn. You know, it was updated not that long ago. Like last time I updated it was when I smoothed the mountain and removed all the blockiness, and when I redid the track inside. I think that was what I did. Oh, and I decorated more too. I just said, you know, I think the Matterhorn's fine the way it is. I don't think there's really any need to mess with it. So yeah, that's what's coming up for Fantasyland, guys. And I really hope you love the update. So I just want to again make it clear that we are not riding any of the new or checking out the new stuff today, just because. But I don't know how long it'll take. I would imagine probably not too long, considering we're all kind of out of school right now. So, yeah, I think I'm going to be kind of trying to groove and get a lot of stuff done. Anywho, thank you guys for watching this video. If you're excited for the Fantasyland update, give the video a thumbs up. And, yeah, that's it. I'll see you guys later. Peace out.